Back in the early 60s, the Los Angeles department store landscape was dotted with local favorites, such as Robinson's, Bullock's, and the Broadway. On September 22, 1960, ground was broken for a brand new department store at the southeast corner of Wilshire and Fairfax. This store was Seibu, a major upscale Japanese department store, choosing the City of Angels as its first foray into the international market. By this time, LA just recently surpassed Philadelphia to become the third most populous city in the nation, and the company saw lots of growth potential. Seibu's aim was to bring something new and fresh to this growing city, the likes it has never seen before. Being the last department store built on the Miracle Mile, Seibu chose to distinguish its design from the stores of Miracle Miles past. Renowned Los Angeles architects, Welton Becket and Associates, designed the building with an elegant simplicity, a mid-century modern take on the exotic Japanese products sold inside. Included in the project was a multi-level parking structure for about 550 cars which integrated with the store. A unique and very popular feature of the store was a fourth-floor glass pavilion that included a restaurant surrounded by a Japanese garden and reflecting pool. This place was the place to dine as it offered good food and an amazing view of the Hollywood Hills. Although it opened with much fanfare, the store proved unprofitable, and the store closed permanently in 1964. Seibu's international venture failed due to one main reason. The general consumers at that time were not ready for upscale and high-end Japanese imports on offer. After the closure, the building was later occupied by Orbach's department store from 1969 until 1986. In 1994, the building was breathed new life as the Peterson Automotive Museum. However, a 2015 renovation of the museum left the original building unrecognizable. While the Seibu experiment in Los Angeles flopped terribly, it didn't stop other Japanese retailers from entering the Southern California market. Just 16 years later, in 1980, Matsuzakaya, another venerable Japanese department store, opened its doors in Little Tokyo. But that's a story for another video. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. This is Chutney Bay, signing off.